see everyone today. We are just so happy. Today is Feast of Tabernacles celebration, the season of our rejoicing. Hallelujah!
Hallelujah!
Shout and praise!
Hallelujah!
We're going to start today by reading Psalm 76. We're going to ask our brother to read.
Psalm 76. Please rise for the reading of the word. In Judah, God is known. His name is great in Israel. In Salem also is his tabernacle and his dwelling place in Zion. There he broke the arrows of the bow, the shield and sword of battle. Salah. You are more glorious and excellent than the mountains of prey. The stout-hearted were plundered. They have sunk into their sleep, and none of the mighty men have found the use of their hands. At your rebuke, O God of Jacob, both the chariot and horse were cast into a deep sleep. You yourself are to be feared, and who may stand in your presence when once you are angry? You caused judgment to be heard from heaven. The earth feared and was still. When God arose to judgment to deliver all the suppressed of the earth, surely the wrath of man shall praise you. With the remainder of wrath, you shall gird yourself. Make vows to the Lord your God and pay them. Let all who are around him bring presents to him who ought to be feared. He shall cut off the spirit of the princes. He is awesome to the kings of the earth.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise be to our awesome God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many of you know he's an on-time God?
All right.
Praise God. Yes. Hallelujah. Well, let's join together and sing. Clap your hands. Grab a flag. Grab a tambourine. And lift your voice.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Praise God.
He's good.
God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. Praise God. But we came here today to worship Him, to present ourselves before our most holy God in repentance and in awe.
Open my eyes, let me
you today in spirit and in truth.
These walls are hallowed, and the seat where you're sitting is holy ground. Amen. But we are the church.
Amen.
We are the body of Christ. We are the house of God.
Amen.
How many can say God lives in them?
Amen.
Amen. He lives in me. Amen. And what holds those stones together, those living stones together, is the love of God. That's the cement that holds the living stones together. So that's who we are. Amen.
Amen.
And that's why we can sing hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come on. Let's do it now. Say, do it in a holy way. Say, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. He truly is worthy of all of our praises. Amen. Amen. I just want you to enjoy and put your hands together. Tap your feet if you want. Clap your hands. Do your dance. I know we got some dancers in the house. You know, if y'all want to dance, you can do that too, because he's worthy of all of our praise.
Extol him with music and with song.
play and dance is going to happen in the place now. Come on, put your hands together. Y'all know the song by now. Come on, sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
This song came about from the Lord. He inspired it through me at a time when I was going through. I had a near-death experience a few years back. And all I could do was praise Him because I was too sick to do anything else. And I was in the bed and I was just praising God and giving Him glory that's due His name. And this song came to me, and I was in the praises of God. But how many know when you're in the presence of God, He shows you things? Amen. That's the God we serve. He wants to whisper to you and say great things to you in the quiet times. Sometimes we need to quiet down the world so that we can hear what God has to say.
Amen.
Amen. And I like it when God speaks to you, because you just feel a warmth. There was a warmth that came over me. And somehow I knew, even though I was in that sick bed, that I would be healed.
Amen.
Right. Amen. Because I read the word, and it said, with His stripes, we are healed. Not was healed, not going to be healed, but it says we are healed. Because some of you know He did a work already, and it's a finished work.
Amen.
He didn't say, well, I'll give you a little bit of healing now, and then later on I'll come by and give you the rest. No, He did all the work He needed to do at the cross.
Amen.
And when this song came out, I just kept hearing the Lord say, by Your stripes. By Your stripes. By Your stripes I am healed. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
physical healing, because some people out there need physical healing. Whether you need emotional healing, and all of us need some healing in emotional areas. Whether it be a spiritual healing you need, or mental healing. Sometimes you need God to regulate your mind. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Or financial healing. You need a financial healing. Whatever the healing is, He did it all at the cross.
Amen.
By His stripes, we are healed.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, brother. Praise God. Hallelujah. But we can have the next slide. This is how I'm keeping up with what we're doing. Praise God. Oh, yes. I know what we're doing next. We're going to introduce Pastor Charlotte, who's going to briefly describe to us why we are meeting here today. Please come.
Careful giving a preacher a microphone. Okay. And it is awesome to actually be here to see all of you again. And she asked me to bring my flute, and she really did not understand what it means to have a flute player on Sukkot. A lot of people don't know that that is biblical. Some of you have, I handed out our Sukkot program that we did. Some of you have it, some of you don't. If you don't have it, Dr. Latour too can email it to you. Okay, but I wanted to go over where we are right now. And on Rosh Hashanah, which was last Thursday, the gates were opened. All right, a lot of people don't understand what time it is. This time right now, Tabernacles, is the time where you have your personal audience with the King. You are brought before Him, and He is examining everything you have done in this last year. All right. Very profound time. On Rosh Hashanah, that's when the names are written in the Book of Life, or in the Book of the Wicked, or those who can't seem to make up their mind, and they get 10 days in between for Yom Kippur to make a decision. Last Saturday, judgments were entered into. At the end of Sukkot, that's when judgments entered into and sealed begin to be executed. But this is your time right now to go before the King. Isn't it wonderful? Kings only call kings before kings.
Amen.
So you are kings.
Hallelujah.
Okay, you are kings. And see, it's very important to understand this is the season of our joy, the season of ingathering. It's the Feast of the Nations, the Feast of Dedication, and the Festival of Lights. But more importantly, this is the timing of the birth of Yeshua.
Amen. Amen.
This holiday is the celebration of the birth of Yeshua.
Amen.
People don't do that.
Amen.
This is all about Him.
Praise the Lord.
And see, on the fourth day when He created the sun, moon, and stars, He wrote a story in the sky. Right now, if you were to look up in the sky for astronomy, not astrology, you see two constellations next to each other. One of them is Beulah, which in Greek is Virgo. It's the virgin giving birth, and right next to her is the lion of the tribe of Judah with his paw on the serpent, crushing the serpent. So right now, every year, you didn't know that the story was telling you this was the time of his birth.
Amen.
Okay, and John says, and what did he do? The word became flesh and tabernacled among us. So this holiday, he is the reason for the season. He is the reason for the season. But I started talking to you about the flute. And the flute and the Sukkot ceremony, celebration. If you have the booklet, it's on page 9, just briefly. As each of the party reached their prospective gates, a trumpet shofar was blown. Then one man would stand up and play the flute. Because the flute represents the Messiah. The flute represents the Messiah. The flute player is called the Pierced One. The flute is pierced, and Yeshua was pierced during the crucifixion. The flute player led the procession. The Pierced One blows the call for the wind and the water to enter the temple.
Amen. Amen.
And as they walked, the willows would make a swishing sound like the wind. And the word for wind in Hebrew is ruach, or spirit. Yeah. It must have sounded like the wind approaching the city. And that's a picture of Pentecost. The shofar was blown as they reached the prospective gates. And then, once again, a man stood up and played the flute. It was the flutist who led the pilgrims up to Jerusalem to worship as the call went out. Come, let us go up to the mountain of Yahweh.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay.
The word for flutist in Hebrew is halah, meaning the pierced one. The pierced one led the people up to the temple. This pierced one, which was certainly a reference to Messiah, whose hands, feet, and side were pierced on the cross, sounded the call for the ruach and the water to enter the temple.
Amen.
So that is why the flute is so profound during Sukkot, because it represents the coming of the Lord. Okay, it represents you being led to your personal meeting. And I know she said 5 or 10 minutes, I have maybe 3 minutes left. I have to play. Okay. And I was up almost all night tossing and turning because there's somebody that Yah wants this song to minister to. And the name of the song is His Eyes on the Stone. Okay. And all, you got my back? All right. All right, and so this is for someone here who is going through something. All of us are going through something, but there's someone here who needed a word from the Lord. And see, when the flute player plays, those words, actually notes, go into words and will minister to you. So that is always my prayer, okay, that the music minister and go and begin to heal all of those places that need to be. If you know the song, please feel free to sing along with me. It's going to be a medley, His Eyes on the Sparrow, Then I May Go into Amazing Grace, or Amen. Yes, Yeshua Loves Me. I don't know. I'll let the Spirit go. Okay, decide how we're going to do this.
Amen. can have the next slide, Gary. Keep up with where we are. Hallelujah. Keep your head up. Hallelujah. Keep your head up. Praise God. We're going to welcome Brad. Hallelujah.
All right, Brad. All right. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give God some praise. Hallelujah. Come on, let's praise his name. The King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes, he is.
Hallelujah.
Yes,
hallelujah. He is greatly to be praised.
Hallelujah.
Like you said, keep your head up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise his name.
Psalms 33. For you, O Yahweh, are a shield for me, my glory, and the one who lifts up my head. Psalm 27:6, and now my head shall be lifted up above my enemies all around. Therefore, I will offer sacrifices of joy in this tabernacle. I will sing, yes, I will say praises to Yahweh.
Come on.
Come on.
You know how I roll the show, torn rap and street and the flow. We believe that we'll see what God will. We'll bring the truth, what you want, that's so real. Shut the light in the dark. I look to my father, he died on a tree. What about all the things that he's done? It doesn't matter, he'll take you to the kingdom. Walk in front, the life is white clean. A new year, a new way, all that king. So it's time to get to life, right? Number 31, I found me a good fight. Now I'm ready, my roof got shame. Now I'm ready, my journey begins.
You know.
Yeah.
All right, Ten Commandments.
Come on.
All right.
Praise his name.
Praise his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ten Commandments. Praise.
Psalm 119:21. You rebuke the proud, the curse, who stray from your commandments. Amen. Did you got the
Ten Commandments?
Got to keep the
Ten Commandments.
Honor the
Ten Commandments.
Come on.
Hello. to the one true God in chapter 14. The Feast of Tabernacles is our opportunity to worship God in obedience and faith. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. We would be remiss, however, not to mention the ultimate eternal significance of this feast. Amen?
Amen.
When we read Revelation chapter 21, and I happen to have my phone here. The phone is quick, but it's not that fast. It was fine until somebody changed it to Psalm 76. Praise God. Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 to 4. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and he will be their God.
Hallelujah.
And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true and faithful. Hallelujah. This is, I usually have my Bible up here that I shake. And I say, this is the word of God. This is the word of God. Hallelujah. This is the deepest expression of the intimate fellowship that God has promised to those who have a relationship with him. The tabernacle. The tabernacle is a meeting place between sinful man and a holy God. For above all things, God is holy. Holy. Amen. Through his work on the cross, Jesus created the temple of the believer. I'm a temple, you're a temple where the Holy Spirit indwells us. Amen?
Amen.
But it's not the ultimate, because now we see through a mirror dimly, but then shall we see clearly. Hallelujah. Now we only know a little bit, but then we shall know fully, even as we are fully known. We are all still mortal, and we have not seen God in the fullness of his glory, where he dwells in an approachable light. Nevertheless, Jesus said, blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God.
Yes.
Hallelujah. So here, we're reading on our phone. Whoops. We're reading here on our phone, hallelujah, of all the blessings. He will dwell with them, it says, and they shall be his people. Of all the blessings of the eternal state that we have inherited, this is by far the greatest.
Yes.
It is, in fact, the greatest blessing found in all of Scripture. The great purpose of Yeshua, our Messiah, since the creation of Adam, I tell you, every tabernacle, every temple, every sacrifice, every correspondence between God and man has been with this ultimate goal in mind, that God will dwell with his people eternally. Amen.
Yes.
We dream of the restoration of full fellowship between God and man, and ultimately the whole earth. I am telling you the truth. The whole earth will become a big sukkah booth for God.
Yes.
And he will reign, and we will reign with him in the presence of his son for all eternity. That is why the Tabernacles Feast is the season of our joy. Amen. Shout to the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Well, right now, we're going to welcome, what's the next slide? Mary, that we go up these slides. By the way, okay, back up. I'll just give a quick testimony for this little boy. I just came back from Zimbabwe, Africa. I was there on a mission. And the mother brought me this little boy and said, you know, I said, what's the problem? He said, he can't hear. He's not speaking. He can't hear. Well, obviously, if you can't hear, you can't speak. And I felt led by the Holy Spirit. And I said, yes, he can hear. And I put the stethoscope in his ear. And I put the dome over my heart. And he looked at me because he could hear. And I cannot tell you the amazement in his eyes when he realized that he could hear. And he could hear. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. All right. Next up, next slide. We're going to welcome Christopher. Christopher came all the way from California to be with us today.
How are we doing?
All right, awesome.
Awesome. All right, so before I get into my song, if everybody could get out the Bible. If you don't want to, that's fine. But Ecclesiastes 2, verse 17, I can just give you the preface for, you know, I write a million songs, but not most of them are very suitable for church. But this one is. So, a very spiritual song. I was actually, I wrote this song, it's called Something About the Dark, but I wrote it in the happiest time of my life. I was 24, and life couldn't get better. I didn't have to ask mom and dad for no money. I had a credit card, I had my own apartment, everything was good. And I knew it wouldn't last, but it's that's just the way that life is. So, 2 verse 17. Hallelujah, if you're there. Okay, all right, cool. Toil is meaningless. So I hated life because the work that is done under the sun was grievous to me. All of it is meaningless, a chasing after the wind. I hated all the things I had toiled for under the sun because I must leave them to the one who comes after me. And who knows whether that person will be wise or foolish. Yet they have control over all the fruit of my toil which I have poured my effort and skill under the sun. This too is meaningless. So my heart began to despair over all my toilsome labor under the sun. For a person may labor with wisdom, knowledge, and skill, then they must leave all they own to another who has not toiled for it. This too is meaningless and a great misfortune. What do people get for all the toil and anxious striving with which they labor under the sun? All their days they work, their work is grief and pain. Even at night their minds do not rest. This too is meaningless. A person can do no better, can do nothing better than to eat and drink and find satisfaction in their own toil. This too, I see, is from the hand of God. For without him, who can eat or find enjoyment? To the person who pleases him, God gives wisdom, knowledge, and happiness. But to the sinner, he gives the task of gathering up and storing wealth to hand it over to the one who pleases God. This too is meaningless, a chasing after the wind. So really, the most important part right here in the section that inspired me to write the song is a person can do nothing better than to eat and drink and find satisfaction in their own toil. This too, I see, is from the hand of God, which is true. Everything comes from God. Everything good comes from God. Everything that you perceive might be bad comes from God too. So that's really where the song is. And there's a lyric of someone should get a cup of pleasure and take it straight. So people might take that as, oh, just get a drink and take it straight. But it's like, no, you find your pleasure, find it in God, and just take it straight up. Just give yourself your all to it. So, anyway, I hope you guys enjoy it. I'm playing this one solo. The next one you guys can join. Thank you.
right hand for the letter Shem and Shaddai. Hallelujah. Give you peace. You are